Welcome to Stella Damasus Diaries. How are you? You know, sometimes you could just sit down and wonder, you know, how fast your days have been going and how tired you have become, especially when you're a parent or you're a married woman or man and you're like, oh my goodness, I am so tired. I have done so much and I don't think I'm seeing enough results. But you know, don't worry about it. There's a time and there's a season for everything. We'll keep praying for each other and everything will be all right, okay? I just thought to give you a little inspiration there. Okay, so what I want to talk about today is what I like to call man and woman matter. It's about marriages. It's about the relationship between a husband and a wife. And there are some do's and don'ts. I don't care what anybody says to anybody. I'm saying that there are just some things that you cannot discuss as regards your marriage, okay? If you're a married man or a married woman, no matter how close anybody is to you, even if you have a best friend that's extremely close to you, please, I beg of you, keep your bedroom affairs to yourself. Because women, we do it a lot. We women, we do it a lot. We hang out with our girlfriends and because we're so close, we just think it's okay to start talking about how good our husbands are in bed, the size of their manhood, how funky they can be, all the gymnastics and acrobatics and things they can do. They can flip and do jumping jacks and you start to fill your friend's head with all sorts of details about your sex life. Sister, stop. I'm sorry, but you have to stop. That doesn't work. In fact, it works against you. You know why? The human mind is very graphic. It's very detailed. You know how somebody is telling you a simple story and as the person is telling you, even if you were not there or you've never been in the area that they're talking about, you can actually trace it and paint pictures of what the place could have looked like or and the imagination of the person that they might be talking about. You just start to play the whole story. That's how the human mind works. You are able to tell the story. As the person is telling you verbally, you are able to create that picture in your mind. Now, imagine this. A married woman is sitting with you and telling you all the details about her husband, how he is in bed, how he behaves, how he moans, all the graphic and nitty-gritty things that you are not supposed to be saying. You are saying it to somebody else, knowing that that person's mind is very graphic and creative. Guess what? The next time that friend of yours sees your husband, she will never see your husband the same way. She will never see him the way she used to see him before. Don't let anybody deceive you. This is how it works for everybody. Open your eyes, my dear sister. When that friend of yours sees your husband the next time, she will greet him, hello, oh, how are you? Long time, trust me, that how are you? Long time. She's remembering those pictures she had painted in her head based on what you said to her. She's looking at the man's face, but she's imagining something else. She's imagining the length, the breadth, the width. She's imagining the jumping jack that he's doing in the bed and everything. And if you're not careful, if that girlfriend of yours is not a very strong-willed person or is not a married woman who loves God, the image of the woman on that bed that she's imagining will no longer be you who's telling the story. The image will turn to her who's listening to the story and painting those pictures. So please, be careful with what you tell your friends. You can tell them, oh, my husband is a good man, and end it there. We don't need to know how our husbands behave in bed, because that's when that friend outside will now start to listen to all you are saying and imagining and wishing and hoping. And if for any reason your husband feels that, oh, this is my wife's friend, she's not looking bad, you know, if he as much as gives her a little hint with all the pictures you have painted in her head, trust me, it would take thunder to stop her from saying yes, because every woman wants to be satisfied. Yes, I'm Stella, yes, and I'm talking about it. Every woman wants to be satisfied sexually. So if your husband is satisfying you sexually, just say thank God. Keep it to yourself and smile and be happy. Don't go and distribute the information to other people who probably are not getting the satisfaction they need from their own husbands. And then when they see your own husband, they are imagining. And then they go home and then their husband is not performing as much as your own husband. And they're like, I wish my husband would be like this man. And then they see that man and they're like, wow. To think that this man is like this. And then if the man as much as touches their hand, that's the end. Their mind We are humans. We are human beings. So you can say some things to your friends that are private, but please save yourself all this wahala. Keep that information about your sex with your husband to yourself. Your friend doesn't need to know because there's nothing she can do about it. If you have a problem with your sex life with your husband, go and see a therapist. Pray about it. Do something or say it to somebody that can help the situation. Not a friend that has nothing to offer you, okay? It might sound harsh, but trust me, that's the reality of life. I hope I've inspired you. I hope I'm speaking to somebody somewhere whose business is to go around telling people about her husband and what her husband does in bed and all of that. Stop. Okay? Stop. You're doing more harm to yourself than you can ever imagine. All right, people, thank you for sticking with me today. Remember, it's not who people say you are, it's who God says you are. I'll see you soon.
Undiluted with Stella Damasus every Monday on i2radio.net.